Hi, hunters! In this video, we are looking at particular examples of how to extend the malware analysis possibilities by using raw view of the file system operations, registry events, and embedded filter. It helps you detect malware families and also get more valuable information about analyzed malware samples. Also, we're going to uncover the kill switch of the ransomware sample. There is a task in which Holocaust Alert has been detected. As you can see, it was detected at least by network signature, but we need to make sure. So, let's go to advanced details of the tagged process. This is the only one created file in the friendly mode, which shows a tiny part of the files, registry operations and events. This mode displays to users mostly file operations, which have ended it with creating a file or directory, and manipulations with the registry, which have led to writing keys. If we switch to the raw mode, we'll see many more operations, both of the file system and registry. This mode doesn't display only successful file operations, but also failed. For example, the malware tries to locate a file or directory with a specified name and hasn't found it. In this mode, analyst also can see any operations with the registry, such as reading, deleting, and others. Let's expand the filter menu. It gives you the ability to filter out irrelevant events by choosing values in drop-down menus. There is the filtering by file name, file system operations, access, type of created operation, operation status value, by device, and object type. And now, let's talk more work. Holocaust malware family is also known as Holocaust Reborn, and some other samples have requested file operations with such file names. Let's choose unknown type as an object, supersede as a type of creating, and also create as operation, and file read attributes as access. Now we need just scroll down a little. There is a Holocaust exactly. So, if you think that the malware sample in front of you is Holocaust, you can write reborn in the file name line and save a lot of time. Now, we're switching from operations with files to operations with folders. As you can see, this task has been tagged as MassLogger Stealer. If you open the file log.txt, we'll see there are lines MassLogger, but we need to check it. Let's switch to the raw mode, expanded filter, and choose directory as an object. We haven't seen any folders with specific names in the friendly mode, so we can suggest that such directory hasn't been created. Based on that, we're choosing status not zero. We don't need to filter out operations more, or even to scroll down, because the directory MassLogger bin is right there. Now you're familiar with the advanced event interface, and you can confirm your guesses using these tools, and also speed up the analysis time by eliminating irrelevant information. Let's continue our tutorial and go to the next part where we're talking about expanding our analysis and using ANY.RUN's interactivity widely. In front of us, the task with ransomware. So for a better understanding of what's going on there, we're restarting it. We're adding the duration time and pressing the run button. In this task, we will search Killswitch for this ransomware using file operations filter, and after we'll test how it works. Let's run the malware executable file by double-clicking. As you can see, the launched process, creating its child processes and even running a part of them as a service. WMI app suffix Z has made a lot of file operations. So let's take a look at advanced details of this process. There are many files which are encrypted, and also some ransom note files. So we have no doubt, it's ransomware. Now let's back to the parent process LMT group, which we ran at the beginning of the task, and take a look at its advanced details. Friendly mode tells us little information, and we're switching to the raw to get more. Let's suggest that ransomware searches Killswitch, which is a file. We need to choose a file as an object, and because we're expecting that Killswitch file hasn't been successfully created, we're choosing not zero in status filter. There are still many events, so let's filter by create operation. Well, now we've found something worthy of our attention. The file with a speaking name, AAA.touchmenot.txt, has been created in the root of the C drive. Let's copy this file name to make easier next steps. Now we're stopping the task because there is nothing valuable for us anymore. Let's restart this task and try Killswitch in action. So we're going to create this file with our own hands. We're changing in the settings the folder from which the sample runs to the desktop, just in case, and launching the task. Now we need to create the AAA.touchmenot.txt file, so let's open Notepad. It's a standard program and you can find it in the Start menu. Because we need to create this file in the root of the C drive, we're running Notepad as administrator. After, we're pasting previously copied file name into remote clipboard and sending it into the virtual machine. Now we're saving a text file with the needed name. And now it's time to try our supposed kill switch and run malware executable file. We're closing all windows. As you can see, process LMT group exe has stopped its executions like other processes. Let's figure out why it happened. We're going to advance details again and switch to the raw events mode. Once more, we're picking file and create, but choosing status 0 instead of null 0, because this time the file has been created. And status 0 means that operation completed successfully. We're scrolling down to the bottom, and yeah, here it is. So, we can conclude that if the ransomware encountered the successfully created AAA.touchmenot.txt file, it stops execution and follows encryption of the files. Today, we have reviewed how to find unobvious things using the advanced settings of ANY.RUN and also uncovered the kill switch of the ransomware sample. Hope this video was proved useful for you and it will help in your further analysis. Thank you for watching the video to the end. Press thumb up if you like it and subscribe to ANY.RUN channel for avoiding to miss useful videos about malware analysis with ANY.RUN Interactive Malware Sandbox. Bye!